Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Vue AutoComplete component of Syncfusion. Imagine that you are asked to enter a book name, but you remember only the partial name of that book. At this time, you would prefer to get a help from the suggestion list that displays the names relevant to your partial typed in text. Here comes the Vue AutoComplete component of Syncfusion that allows you to display the relevant suggestion list for the typed in characters. You can also bind local and remote data to the autocomplete, do filtering, grouping, as well as customize its UI with templates. Now, in this video, I will show you the steps to create a Vue project using the Vue CLI tool and will edit my code using the Visual Studio code, and finally, I can view the output result on any of the supported browsers. Okay, let me open the Visual Studio code, and now, to create a new Vue project, I may need to install the Vue CLI tool globally on my machine using the command npm install -g at vue/cli. As I've already installed it in my machine, I'm skipping this step here. Now, let me create a new Vue project using the command Vue create autocomplete component. Here, I have named my project as autocomplete component. This will create an empty Vue application with no Syncfusion packages. Now, I will navigate to the newly created application folder. The autocomplete is available under the EJ2 Vue dropdowns package, and therefore, to start using the autocomplete component in my application, first, I need to install the dropdowns package using the command npm install at syncfusion/EJ2VueDropdowns. This command will install the autocomplete plugin along with its dependencies. Once the installation gets completed, my application is now ready to use the autocomplete component. The first thing I need to do here is to register the autocomplete plugin from Syncfusion EJ2VueDropdowns package. For that, I will open the app.vue file, and here, to have clear focus on autocomplete code, I am removing the default code snippet under the template, script, and style section. As a first step, I will import Vue from Vue package, and then let me import the autocomplete plugin from Syncfusion EJ2VueDropdowns package. Also, I need to register the same plugin globally inside the API Vue.use to register all child directives globally. Now, within the template section, I will define the EJS-autocomplete tag inside the div element. To align my autocomplete better on the output page, I have defined a div element with few CSS styles. The next thing is, I need to define the CSS for Vue autocomplete component. So, let me import this component CSS using the CDN link under the style section. Okay. Let me save the application and run my application with the command npm run serve. This will start the development server and automatically reloads the page at any time whenever I make edits on my project. So here, you can see the autocomplete with no items. Now, to populate the items, I may need to bind data source for the autocomplete component. For that, let me open the app.vue file, and within the data function, I will define the object variable data item and assign the array of objects where each object holds two fields, namely ID and game. Now, I will map this data source field name to the appropriate options within the fields property of autocomplete component. So here, I need to define the data fields variable and map this game field to the value property. Now, let me assign this data item to the data source property of the autocomplete component. And I also assign this data fields variable to the fields property. This data source contains a list of sports names. So, let me define the property placeholder with the value select a game, which will be displayed as the placeholder text on the autocomplete. Look at the autocomplete now. When I start to type in some characters, You can see the pop-up displaying the sports name in its suggestion list relevant to my typed-in text. You can also notice that the autocomplete displaying a short description as select a game as its placeholder text. Here, by default, the pop-up width is 100% and height is 300 pixels, but you can also set custom height and width to it. To set custom height and width for the pop-up, I need to define the pop-up width and pop-up height properties with the required custom values. So now, look at the autocomplete component where the pop-up is displayed with custom height and width. Suppose, if I want to bind remote data source to Vue AutoComplete, then I may need to make use of Data Manager library of Syncfusion. The Data Manager acts as a gateway between the autocomplete and data source and also uses queries to interact with both the local and remote data source. So, as a first step, I need to import the Data Manager and required adapter from Syncfusion EJ2 data repository. Now, within the data function, let me replace the JSON data collection with the Data Manager instance. Then, I will set the Data Manager properties like URL, adapter, and cross domain. In the URL, I will be assigning the existing remote URL service, which will retrieve the list of data through post action and return the resultant data to the Vue autocomplete. This remote URL service will return a collection of data objects with fields like employee ID, first name, designation, and country. Also, I have set the Web API adapter to the adapter property as the URL set here is of Web API service type. And cross domain option is set to true to allow the cross origin domain request. Now, I need to map the remote data source field, so I will map this first name field to the value property. Then, I need to retrieve the data items from data source based on the typed in characters and bind it to the autocomplete, so I will frame the query to fetch the data items. Now, I need to import query from Syncfusion EJ2 data repository. Within the data function, I will define a variable data query with the query instance. Here, I am going to retrieve employee names, so I have formed a select query using two remote data source fields, namely first name and employee ID. Now, let me assign this variable data query to the query property of the autocomplete. As I have assigned the employee names to the data source now, let me change the placeholder property value as select a name. Also, let me ensure whether this data item and data fields variable are assigned to the data source and fields property of the autocomplete. And now, you can see the autocomplete which lists out the employee names in its suggestion list. In case, if I want to highlight my typed in characters visually on the resultant suggestion list, then I may need to make use of the highlight property. Now, let me define the highlight property and set its value as true. So here, when I type in the characters, autocomplete highlights the searched characters in its suggestion list like this. Okay, now let me summarize some of the important points which we have discussed so far. We have seen how to add the Vue autocomplete of Syncfusion to the Vue application. Also, we have seen how to populate JSON data and remote data source to the autocomplete and how to highlight typed in characters in the suggestion list, as well as how to set custom height and width for autocomplete pop-up. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link which I have shared in the description part below. And if you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.